Valvular heart disease is a disease of the valves of the heart. We have four heart valves. The valves can become narrow, and therefore they can prevent the blood to flow appropriately through the heart, or they can become regurgitant, means leaky valve, some of the blood so regurgitated backward. The symptoms of valvular heart disease are usually chest pain, shortness of breath, palpitations, dizziness, or lightheadedness, especially during exertion. Valvular heart disease is diagnosed, first of all, with a transthoracic echocardiogram in which we apply a probe to your chest. The ultrasound generates images of the valves, so we can image and see the anatomy of the valves. This is the transthoracic echocardiogram. However, sometimes in order to get more details about the valve disease, we need to perform a transesophageal echocardiogram through which a probe goes through your mouth and is able to image as you go through the esophagus, which is behind the heart, getting more detailed assessment of the valves. If a valvular heart disease goes untreated, can cause heart failure. So you start becoming more short of breath. You start developing also swelling of your legs, and also can cause changes in the structure and the anatomy of the heart. And as a consequence, you can develop arrhythmias, which are irregular heartbeat, which sometimes could be also life-threatening. To treat valvular heart disease, we have different procedures and methods. We can have the traditional surgery, in which we have to perform a thoracotomy, cut the chest, open the chest, and then go and replace the valve, which is not working effectively. However, recently we have more techniques which are less invasive, through which we can go through the artery of the groin, through the heart, and then we can or replace the valve, or we can put some clips to avoid the valve to be regurgitant.